Empirical study of the top management, their skills and abilities case. Firms in Cuernavaca, Morelos, Mexico.
Abstract. Objective. Identify and analyze the lack of skills and competences from the senior management of companies in Cuernavaca, Morelos, that have a direct impact in their growth and development. Methods. The study is being realized on the higher management of the micro, small, and medium companies of Cuernavaca. The quantitative descriptive study type of field, a questionnaire was applied with 64 items directed to 49 managers and executives. This one was validated by 3 experts and their reliability of 0.887, calculated through the Alpha-Cronbach coefficient. Theoretical framework. It's theoretically sustained in Ales, 2007, Ariza, 2005, Zubiria, 2006, Hellriegel, 2002, Levy-Leboyer, 2003, and Pelekais, 2008, among others.
Entering the organizational game. Business administration is a problem that relapses and is mainly responsibility of the executive, either in the owner role or the manager of the company. It's important in both roles to take the organization to a future growth and development in a local and globalized world, in a constant change and fierce competitiveness. For those who pretend to survive in a small or large business, not only is hard work necessary if not doing it in a smart way, but do managers, owners, and directive know about this? High directives are responsible in last instance for the failure or success in a company on the accomplishment for performance expectations at least every 3 months. High directive places include the CEO, the president, the vice president, the owner, and the managers from different companies such as micro, small, and medium. Develop business policies, goals, and objectives. Plan and control the actions and relations on the company. It must be careful due to the decisions will change the future of the company.
The importance. In investigations such as the ones from Galbraith and Nathanson, Schuller and Tariq, we found the importance that the investigation has about the high direction as a primordial element in the formulation and implementation of strategies that can perpetuate the company. Thus, in the last 20 years, the number of models proposed to explain the importance that observes as a study phenomenon the high direction as a function of non-strategic important matter, if not as a vital sign, has been multiplied substantially. Due to this, and the lack of theoretical framework to understand the high direction, the administrative discipline had to progressively incorporate arguments and methodologies from very diverse scientific fields, such as strategic direction, economic theories from organization, and even sociological and psychological approaches.
This strategic approximation used to investigate around the high direction is directly bonded to organizational competitiveness. It requires to consider theoretic concepts that exceed form the strict scope of the high direction.
For this reason, many arguments from the strategic, economic, and sociological thought have been incorporated. For example, the agency theories or the transaction costs, the vision of the company based in resources and capacities, or the institutional theory, the narrative, the metaphor, among others.
Literature reviews presented by Wright and McMahon or Jackson and Schuller, such as special dedicated numbers to this subject in magazines like International Journal of Human Resource Management or Human Resource Management Review, that contributed and keep to contribute disciplinary development, reordering models proposed till this moment and collecting new and more relevant contributions.
Quality theorists such as Deming, Crosby, Fingenbaum, among others, they also mention the value of doing the investigation about the high direction. As a consequence from the evolution process that has been described, the investigation about organizational leaderships, the high direction, is configured as a discipline characterized by the multiplicity, theoretical approaches, methodology, and investigation interests. Theories such as Wright and McMahon, Mejia Giraldo, and others sustain and argue that importance. Deloitte plasms in the document named Human Resource Tendencies 2013 and 2014 for Mexico that in the most important tendencies is the challenge in the development of talents and development in the high management. Therefore, it's still necessary to make an effort to value the progress made and integrate the literature that has been boarded during this organizational function. Generally, theorists like Fisher, Mahoney and Decop, Wright and Boswell, agree in distinguishing two complementary ways of understanding this function. 1. A micro-orientation centered around the analysis of the management to each one of the practices of the manager, and 2. A macro point of view with a focus to the study of the strategic role that the manager develops. Chomsky, in Aspects of Theory of Syntax, for example, from Language Theories, established the concept and defines competences as the capacity and disposition for the performance and for interpretation. OCDE, on a study known as DESECO, Definition and Selection of Competencies, defines it as the competence of individual as the result of a mix of attributes that are organized in a combination of diverse tasks. Alles proposes that the competences make reference to the features of the personality, coming from behaviors that generate a successful performance in a job. And Pelekais remarks that the manager is who handles the company. He's careful with everything that works for the functionality of the organization, and the functions are planification, organization, direction, and control. Competition. The concept of competence is multidimensional and includes several levels to know how to do, to know how to be, and to know to be. In other words, the competition capacity of a nice performance in authentic and complex contexts. It's based in the integration and activation of knowledge, skills, abilities, attitudes, and values. Concept of competences, since the perspective of the management and their implications in the organizations of high performance, we consider the arguments from Alles, Ariza, Zubiria, Hellriegel, and Pelekais. This table can show the items and dimension of the instruments exposed above. Organizational analysis and organizational structure investigation. Strategy, digitization of the environment. Culture audits, information systems. Human resource architecture. Mapping techniques of the human resource. Prediction models, among others. Models based around management competences. Digital skills, competitive strategies, competences around models of systemic organizational loyalty, organizational trust, among other elements. This investigation isn't only about knowing the academic formation of the executive, it's about knowing what competences and skills they have on. Issue. Those who create small companies do it without knowing the low probabilities of survival they have. The experience and data prove that 60% of such companies get broke during their first year of activity, and not less than 92% before 5 years. According to a statistical analysis reveals, 95% of these failures are attributable to the lack of competence and experience in the direction of companies dedicated to a specific activity. From a 50 to a 65% of the companies settles on the capital of Morelos, they close their doors in the first year, resulting in a lack of professional advisory and the unknowing of tax issues, the management of the administrative process, and even the acquisition of a credit. To the lack of capacitation tools to the handling of the administrative process, the acquisition of credits, among others, each year, to a 65% of the companies that open are extinguished, resulting in a bad handling by their owners. There are 25,000 economic units in the capital of Morelos, of which 20,000 are up to date with the accomplishment of rules and payments of their obligations. Of this, the 98% are micro companies that profit for Cuernavaca, and 80% of their regular jobs. Unfortunately, between 50 to a 60% of the company close in their first year, government of the state of Morelos. At least in Morelos, the companies that pass their first and fifth year are established as successful companies.
The best way to prevent misfortunes and to shore around solid bases the continuity and growth of the company is recognizing all of those possible factors of compromising it. The results prove that, according to the managers and various executives survive observe perspective, they own personal competences in a high dominance of themselves. Specifically, the self-knowledge, self-realization, and self-control. Likewise, for the management competences in the director, mentor, and facilitator roles with a scores per indicator that surround from 2.98 to 3.44, placing them in the high domain category of the competence. However, for the knowledge dimension, is to say, concepts, disciplinary knowledge, contextual knowledge, procedural knowledge, and the innovative role with the coexisting with changes indicator and creative thinking are placed in a very low domain. On this dimension, they should reflect who manage the universities with degrees in administration and in the end, due to the importance of the themes in the development process framework of their regions. Some general results. General results of the competences that are not found in a group of 49 micro companies. General results of the competences that are not found in a group of 49 small companies. General results of the competences that are not found in a group of 49 medium companies. Thank you.